Howdy folks and all the wonderful subscribers, it's me again, your Chief Ed Olanzi. In this video segment, our discussion is about free surface effects, free surface correction, any calculations and some demonstrations on how it behaves and affects your vessel stability, including your cargo containment structures. This is a very important concept and application on board ships, regardless of the type of vessel. However, we will focus on liquid cargo tanks, ballast waters, other compartments like fuel, and even small spaces such as freshwater tanks, etc. The sloshing of liquid is a serious matter. Whether the vessel is in port, discharging or loading operation, unloaded or ballast passage, especially with bad weather like winds and waves from rolling to pitching or even swaying. And this is all in general actually affects all ships of any kinds, of any types, especially the tankers. But it doesn't limit all to tankers at all, even bulk carriers with their ballast tanks and many other types of vessels. So let's begin. Let's discuss first about inertia. The liquid itself has some inertia to it on the surface. And inside the tank, as shown in this drawing, this is effectively reducing or decreasing your ship's metacentric height, or GM. So this is your center of gravity, this is your keel, and this is your metacenter. It decreases your GM, okay? Now, if you remember your basic stability, the ship has so-called initial stability and the GSA, writing R. Now, if there is a liquid sloshing where it was caused by outside forces like wind and waves or even shifting weights from one place to the other, basically the ship is being tipped over from either side or even forward and upward. So as a result of this sloshing, you can expect that the center of gravity will also shift, which we call it ship of G or virtual G, and into that direction, and hence your GM will change. And this is quite very significant with your stability of your vessel. Now let's try to prove this free surface effects by setting an example. In this image here, you could see that there is a sample of a rectangular shaped box, or let's just say it's a tank. And it's slacked, it's a liquid content, it's a white tank with a breadth of 12 meters and with a length of 5 meters. So let's just assume also that the density of seawater, which is of course 1025 kg per cubic meter. And with this formula here to guide us, calculation of pre-surface correction. Pre-surface corrections, or GG1, equals to the density of the tank. And of course, G is the gravitational acceleration, which is 9.81 meter per second square, while the like an I inertia of a tank, it's called moment of inertia of the free surface inside the tank. And of course, you could see, well, you could well see the symbol. It's divided into the displacement of the weight of the ship. Now let's just assume that the weight of the ship is, as you can see there, it's about 3.634 exponent to the 6th power. And with that formula, 5 meters times 12 and multiplied to itself to 3 and divided by 12 is about 720 meter to the 4th. So with this, we have now the so-called inertia of the tank. Now we follow with the formula given, which is density times gravitational acceleration times the inertia of the tank, which is 1025 kg per cubic meter times 9.81 meter per second square times 720 meter to the fourth divided by 3.634 exponent to the 6, which is 3,634,000, and thus we have a value of 1.99 meters. Now, as you can see the shape, we tried to reposition the tank by putting it into the longitudinal length of the vessel, and as you can see again in these computations, now the breadth is about 5 meters while the length is 12 meters. So with that value given, if we try to do the computations, 12 meters times 5, and 5 which is multiplied itself to 3, and divided by 12 is 125 m to the 4th. So with this formula, again, we have a value of 0.34 meters. So you can see the first one, as shown earlier, is transversely positioned in perpendicular to the longitudinal length of the bezel, while this one is placed along the longitudinal plane of the bezel. And 1.99 versus 0.34 meters has a big difference. Now, if we try to do another computation, let's say this longitudinal position, as you being shown right now, we double the thumbs with the same size, and then we recalculate again the free surface effect with the same size of this rectangular thumb, then you could see that we have the same value of 0.34. And even if we sum them up together, it's still gonna be like 0.68 meters. It's still a far cry compared to the only one thumb which was placed in a transverse position in perpendicular to the longitudinal plane of the bezel, which is 1.99. So we can hereby conclude that dividing a thumb into two or even more would reduce significantly the free surface effects. And if you sum them up together, the value would be less. This is why free surface effects are very important in every part of the bezel. So if we are doing in actuality, then we could see that all tanks, like ballast tanks, the cargo tanks, if you are in a tanker, including fuel tanks and other spaces where liquid is moving or sloshing, they are all summed up altogether. Of course, we cannot do that if we compute it individually. It would take us a long time. So it's a good thing that we have now the so-called loading computer, which is, of course, aids us in doing the calculation faster. Now, I'm going to show you later another comparison using loading computer applications, and we will be able to determine actually. But this computation alone would really, what we call that, conclude or confirm that such kind of design for tanks, even if they are in different shapes, like for LNG, we have the so-called hexagon type and prismatic type for LPG, while the rest of the tanks in other ships for oil tankers, it could be a little bit of a resembles to a rectangular shape, but all of this has its own inertia and they are computed accordingly. Now let's try to prove a little bit of calculation here by using a loadicator. So as you can see here, the tanks are actually full, and it's in one of them, and some, of course, other tanks are filled with fuel oil, etc., and so on and so forth. Now looking at this GM right now, it's GM is 3.63, which has been corrected. The kg, actual kg was 12.39, which of course, if we apply the free surface correction, then it will get GM corrected of 3.65 meters. And of course, the actual kg is about 12.22. Actually, this is a little bit confusing. This should be called as kg, solid kg, so that if you subtract the pre-surface correction, then you'll get a so-called fluid kg of 12.22. And also this GM correction is also termed as GM, fluid GM. Okay, anyway, if you look at these numbers, which is already shown, let's go to this selection here on condition, and remember those numbers, and I will tick the pre-surface or sort of maximize the computation on the pre-surface effect to be applied on each tank. So I'm just gonna tick on all of these boxes here. Of course, I'm just gonna tick it one by one, although I'm not sure if some of them has a content. It could be the ballast tank, fuel tanks, etc., and so on and so forth. Now remember, a small amount of liquid will be detected by the sounding or measuring system, especially the sonar or other means of measuring devices. They could be very sensitive and it gives sometimes a false reading, but it's better safe than never. So as you can see, if we apply that one, remember, check this out, it's a 0.17 pre-surface correction and the GM is 3.63, and I'm gonna press this one again, and in just a matter of seconds it would give us a new value. As you can see, the pre-surface correction now from 0.17 is about 1.58, and you could see that the GM correction from 3.63 meters, which is corrected now, it's about 2.23. so that's the new GM with the applied pre-surface effects. So in actuality, if you are on board ships, basing your GM on this lower value, it's much more better than basing it on the larger value, in a sense that it will give you a means of understanding your stability. At the same time, it keeps you on the safe side. So you know, especially if the ship is very unstable, there are different kind of ships and some of them are designed with the stability that it's not that so good. I mean to say, some ships would probably, when you are fully loaded, it gives you a minimum, almost just a GM of 1.0, and if you are doing something else that is not right with your operation, and it affects the GM so much, then you may end up being in neutral condition or even negative. So hopefully it won't happen to anybody. Now I'm just gonna show you a little bit more of animation. It's basically related to the pre-surface effects, but at the same time you'll be able to see a little bit of entertainment with regards to the behavior of liquid. So as you can see, I intended to close the other liquid drop valve, so I'm gonna open the bulkhead valves. This is of course for prismatic type of LPG. Now this is just only for a demonstration, so it's not applicable to all kinds of ships, but as you can see, if I close the valve on the center bulkheads and I'm gonna roll the vessel, and you'll be able to see that the liquids are actually sloshing from one side to the other. But you see, they are of course separated with one bulkhead, and at the same time the bay fore on top is common, so it's still one, basically one cargo and one tank in reality. So disregard that picture over there. I don't know how it gets stuck. I'm just playing with it and how to make it plot. Anyway, I will simulate a little bit more of that by opening the bulb, and as you can see, this is also for LPG ships fully refrigerated, that if you do not close the so-called bulkhead bulb, so labeling bulb, it will transfer if not fully pulled. See, it's transferring from one side to the other, right? So that has to be closed at all times when you have completed the loading. It's only used to label the liquids evenly. Now I'm gonna take it further by removing the bulkheads. Of course, in reality you cannot remove that, but I'm just simulating it anyway. So now it's gone and it is in one space. So I'll exaggerate the rolling violently. Maybe you have a large GM, and so this is what happens with the liquid inside your cargo tanks with this prismatic shape of cargo containment. All right, so let's go with another demo. This is another, I just take out the hull of the ship and it's all basically the same. So I'm gonna open again. Of course it doesn't behave like that because it should be slowly, and this is huge. All right, and disregard again the picture, it's just plotting. I'm trying to make fun of it. I'm trying to create a float bulb for sounding, and as you can so see, the levels are the same, right? And I'm gonna close the bulb, and of course the behavior of the sloshing of the liquids inside the tanks is also acting as it should. Again, the pre-surface effects, if they are divided into two, then it will be less compared to the pre-surface effects if it's only one and there is no center bulkhead. So I'm gonna remove it, and it goes like that. So you can see the sloshing is much more greater, the inertia of the tanks is much more higher, and you could see the effect will be bigger. And if you have a GM, as I mentioned earlier in the
previous explanation, then it would be catastrophic if you have that kind of slack tanks. Anyway, I intentionally put the levels of the liquid in a very slack position. So if you have this kind of tanks like LNG membrane, which doesn't have a center bulkheads, then it should be full so that there won't be much space of the liquid to slosh from one side to the other. Whilst if you are discharging, it should be discharged all the way down, right? And as I mentioned in the previous video, if you have the so-called ISI or SPB type of cargo containment, this is for gas carriers, you have a lot, you have center bulkheads, and there's a lot of transverse and longitudinal bulkheads that are put in place. So basically, you can put partial cargoes in that kind of tanks, but not with this one. All right. So this is the full explanation of free surface effects and its behavior and the computation that I have demonstrated. I hope that it would help you. But then again, of course, this is just only for the augmentation of learning, and of course to entertain you. You should check with your stability manuals, your ship guidelines, and the proper authority for trainings and learning and expanding your knowledge.